Bill Reeb, chairman of the AICPA. These are unprecedented times requiring an unprecedented response. What is the AICPA's response?
Well, they are unprecedented times. And when you start thinking about the change in routine, the change in what will eventually be the economic state, when you think about the changes in what is considered normalcy, this is a unprecedented event. When you make the comment, what is the AICPA doing about it? I can't say I've ever been more proud to belong to the AICPA, CIMA, the association, because of what they've done with not only the tax return extensions, but with COVID-19, their resource center, and quite frankly, the AICPA has been touted by a number of organizations outside the CPA profession as having one of the most extensive resource centers out there, trying to keep it current. I would also tell you that the association put together a coalition that went to the Treasury, the SBA, banks, to Congress, and said, we need to find a way to get businesses, small business, back in business as soon as this is over. And they formed, if you will, the basic ideas of what came out as the PPP plan, which is going to put 8 weeks of salary in the hands of the worker around the country.
The AICPA has indeed been incredibly busy in mobilizing all of its forces, all of its contacts, all of its members, leveraging every bit of goodwill and influence it might have. How does something like that happen?
One of the things that I think I'm the most impressed about is the fact that I already work very closely with the professional staff of the association. And quite frankly, I would say that they work about 18 hours a day, 6 days a week already. And to think of what they've been doing has been really pretty close to 24/7. You want to talk about how they're marshaling it? When this started going on and we started talking about what the plans were and the amount of resources they would have to put together, the amount of time it would take, it was actually frightening to think, where could they get those resources? They already were operating and pushing themselves, and to think they could come up with even more energy. My biggest concern, and I tell them on a regular basis, is burnout. They are pushing the envelope every day. Why? Because they feel like if we don't take action with our members, if we don't get our members focused, if we don't get our members to help their clients, if we don't get our members in industry back in business, that we feel like the economic realities of this as we turn to normalcy will be devastating.
How is this crisis impacting AICPA members? Who's suffering the most?
When you think about who's suffering the most, I'm going to have to say the small business and the small business worker. I think they are the ones the most affected. And we have basically treated our members as the army that needs to be contacting those small businesses and saying, hey, here's a plan. Here's how we can get everything back operating and running. And how do we push that forward as fast as we can? One of the things that I will tell you is that when you get in a situation like this, it's easy to, I don't want to say get depressed, but it's easy to start looking and having hope fade a little bit. And it's critical that our membership, the CPA profession, is on the front line reminding people we can get through this. We can get through it together. And if we just start taking action, a little bit of action, if we just start moving forward, we will be fine.
Bill, what kind of lasting changes do you see coming out of this?
One of the things that comes up a lot is how this will affect us long term. And the first thing I want to say is that it has already had an amazing effect. The first point I would make is that I think we have fast-forwarded the technology world at least by 5 years. The use of technology has skyrocketed, and people are starting to say, okay, we got to get people working at home, and we have to find ways to communicate with each other during the day. We have to find ways to get people comfortable working remotely. And many, many organizations didn't do that. They didn't have a plan to do that. Why? Because things were going fine. And then you talk about the resilience of so many people out there, restaurants who are closed down, who then said, you know, I've got food. Why don't I become a supply chain part? Why don't I actually sell raw food? Why don't I create nothing but to-go orders since I can't open for business? And it's been amazing how people have had to rethink their strategy and come up with a different way to do business. And my point to all that is that that is going to stay with us. This isn't a one-time event and all of that just goes away and then we go back to the way we were and say that never happened. This is not the last time this is going to happen, but it's not a time to be scared. It's a time to start thinking we are going to, as a society, act different and be different.
And what are you hearing from the front lines, from members in industry?
When it comes to our members in industry, they are on the front line of all of this. And quite frankly, what's interesting about our profession is that half our profession supports the other half of our profession. So bottom line is that our members in industry are the ones that are, in many cases, the small businesses that are working with the PPP loans, and they're the ones that are working with the SBA, and they're the ones that are making sure that they are setting themselves up to survive tomorrow. But that's why this is also important, to make sure that our army of accountants, whether they're in industry or public, are working hand in hand to drive home how do we return to economic normalcy, how do we get ready for when this is considered cleared, that we are ready for the demand that will happen. There is pent-up demand from consumers that have stayed home and sheltered at home and not been able to get and do some of the things they wanted to do. So bottom line is, it's going to be about how fast small business can ramp up to support demand as it comes back online.
This is, for sure, a time of transformational change. What will the profession look like on the other side of this?
The idea that we're going to have more remote working is certainly going to become more of a constant. The idea that we're going to do more communications virtually, I think, is going to be more of a constant. The reality, though, is that it's not like technology will replace everything. It's not like we won't interact as humans together anymore. It's just that we have other choices. And when you had the way we've always done it, it was hard to get everybody on board to say, you know, we could do this a different way. But we have families eating dinner today on a virtual setting. We have people having virtual cocktails. And these kinds of things just were incredibly rare before. And what our world is finding out is there are lots of different ways to do the normal things we do.
You and I were in the same building in Midtown Manhattan on 9/11. We were both working for the AICPA.com, CPA to Biz, it was called at the time. We saw the planes crash into the buildings. We saw the buildings burn and fall, and the world has never been the same since. How will this crisis change life going forward?
We would have never thought we would go through what we do now, to go through security and to get on a plane. And it wouldn't surprise me a bit if the scanners in the near future didn't actually take temperature. It wouldn't surprise me a bit if we didn't have tests before you could get on a flight. All I'm saying to you is what we do now, if you looked at 1990, you would have said that would have never happened. I wouldn't have to virtually undress to try to get through security. But we don't think anything about it today. And so there will be some changes that occur because we need to consider the fact that we are a global economy in an environment where we are packed together all over the world, and we need to think about how that will change the way we operate. And quite frankly, when you start looking at COVID-19, how fast did it spread globally? And that's part of the issue, is we will end up changing and making changes due to the fact that we recognize this may happen again, and we can take some reasonable precautions to keep it from happening at this widespread level.
The AICPA is a global organization since its association with CIMA. What's going on around the world with accountants and this pandemic?
One of the great things about where we are as a profession today is many years ago we started a joint venture between the AICPA and CIMA, and we formed the association. And the association is represented in so many countries. And we work with our professionals all over the world. And I can tell you that it doesn't matter where we are, because we are represented everywhere. We are pushing the same exact message. We're pushing the same exact message in London that we are in New York, which is that small business has to recover, and we need to provide resources and help them recover. So what's great is that we have had not only a global footprint to make a difference all over the globe, but we also have representation globally, which has made a difference in how fast we can get information to our members, how fast we can activate our members to be able to make a difference.
How is this pandemic changing the AICPA itself, changing the way the AICPA does business? A tremendous amount of the AICPA's activities are geared around meetings and conferences. Is everything going to be virtual now?
From an adjustment perspective to what has been going on to service the marketplace, I can tell you it's been phenomenal, the changes that have taken place. So many programs have gone virtual, and they've gone virtual very quickly. So many programs are being converted to part virtual and part in person. So you might see something like an Engage, where we might do something virtually around the time it would have occurred, and then you might see something in person later on in the year. The outcome has been all hands on deck. How do we make sure we're communicating with our members? How do we make sure that we're taking care of our members and that we're not just saying, hey, by the way, we've got problems and we're busy. And what we've said is, no, we are going to take care of our members and we're going to reach out to them. Now, this isn't just the association. This isn't just AICPA and CIMA. It is the state societies doing exactly the same thing. Everybody has said we have to find a way to continue to support our members through this crisis, through this pandemic, and we need to make sure they are ready to come out stronger than they were before.
Bill, what are you hearing from members in public practice? How are they doing?
Our members in public have been great through all of this. They have been very frustrated at the same time because, you know, anytime you put together a program that disperses as much money as the PPP program is, as fast as the PPP program has, and by the way, you want to talk about unprecedented, that is also unprecedented, which I'm proud to say that AICPA was part of leading that. The association was part of leading that. But when you start looking at our members in public, they are small businesses too, and they are being able to react the same way as their clients and be able to get access to the same kind of funding.
Will there be casualties?
It wouldn't surprise me if you had a number of CPA firms decide, very small CPA firms decide, you know, it's time for me to hang up my shingle, because we've had many, many, many of our sole proprietors say, you know, I'm going to stay around and do a couple more years. This may be the year that they say, I'm done. And that could change the marketplace. I'm not suggesting that it should be. I'm just saying it wouldn't surprise me, because the changes taking place require people to think differently. For example, many firms that were never cloud-based, that didn't want to go cloud-based, have said, I need to be cloud-based. I need to be cloud-based because how am I going to have remote workers if I don't have a different structure and a different environment? So it's requiring people to make investments so that they can have remote workers, so that they can have an environment that is more resilient to changes like these.
They say crisis creates opportunity. This is as big a crisis as anybody has ever seen. Are the opportunities as big?
We've got a number of opportunities ahead of us. And I am truly proud to say that the association has been strategically trying to position our profession every year for as long as I've been around in the leadership of the profession. The fact that we made the investment in dynamic audit solutions so that our new audit process can be more virtual and leverages technology puts us in a better position. The fact that we have been working on CPA evolution to bring more technologists, people that have a background in data analytics and are working hand in hand on the assurance side to make sure that we're not just auditing around the computer but through the computer, that process is in place. These are all things that are strategic in nature that now, as you look at the environment, say, wow, that is a fantastic process that we've been under, because it clearly shows we've been moving in the right direction. But one of the things that I think that we have talked about for decades and that is at the forefront of all the initiatives that we look at from a global perspective is we've got to move to the trusted advisor side. When you start talking about opportunity, there is an endless amount of opportunity. When you start talking about how this environment allows our members to be the front line, whether you're in industry or whether you're in public, to be the front line of making a difference, to get our businesses back operational, to get our operations back to profitability, we couldn't be in a better position to be able to make a difference in today's economy. But it always comes back to some of the basics, and some of the basics are we need to stretch our comfort zone, and every single CPA, whether you're in public or industry or education or government, every single CPA needs to say, how do I act more like a trusted advisor? Because if I'm not looking and saying, how could we do things differently? If I'm not looking and saying, what is it that we're doing that we ought to stop doing? If I'm not pushing people to take an inward look at where we are and where we're going, and an outward look at the marketplace that we're serving, then we have failed. And I'm saying to you that this platform that is, quite frankly, a mantra of our profession, that if you ask anybody, they would say, yes, CPAs are trusted advisors. It is time for us to step up and be exactly that, every single one of us.
If it is time for every accountant to step up, where do they start? What's the first thing they need to do to step up?
You know, the first thing we all need to do to step up in a crisis is recognize that we need to change. So many people, when they start thinking about change, say, okay, well, you know, if I get Rick to change, then I'll change. Or if I get someone else to change, if I get my client to change, then I'll change. The first place to start is inward. How do I make myself better in this environment? Once you start making moves, you will start feeling more and more comfortable in a new environment. Once you stop saying, you know, I'm scared that I may not be good at this, you'll find out that you're great at it because you'll start moving forward. Change doesn't happen in a giant overnight change. We will make change in an incremental fashion, but at the same time, if people start thinking, how can I ask better questions? How can I push the envelope in what I'm asking people about? That will make all the changes. If you just sat down with your management group, if you're in industry, you sit down with your client in public and just say, tell me where you are, tell me where you're going, let's talk about the gaps. If you just let go of the fact that you have to have every answer and your job becomes, how do I identify the problem? I will tell you, as being a consultant for 30 plus years, answers are a dime a dozen. And everybody wants to make it about the answers. It is not about the answers. It is about the questions. If you don't know the problem you're trying to solve, you cannot solve it. So we have to take as our drive, as our focus, to say, I'm going to, with everyone I'm working with, understand where they are and understand where they want to go so that I can help them bridge the gap. And no, I may not have all the answers, but I can be the quarterback to make sure that we're finding the resources that we need to put together this puzzle to the point that it becomes a clear picture.
This crisis is bigger than the financial meltdown of 2007, 2008. It's bigger than the dot-com crash of 2002. It's the biggest thing in 100 years, and it's spanning the globe. What's your prediction for how many jobs might be lost in the accounting business because of it?
Number one, I think we will come out of this as a profession better, faster, and stronger than we are. I think it will help us make the changes we know we should have made all along. And as a matter of fact, if there's a comment I've made to many of our clients is, you've known you needed to change, but you were doing so well, you didn't. And you've known your clients needed to make changes, but they were doing so well, they didn't. And now we're in an environment where you need to step up and say, what should I be doing and how do I move forward? What's great about our profession is that we and the role we have is integral to making change in any business. And so I don't see this as a scenario where we don't have opportunity. What I see it as a scenario where some of our people whether you're in industry or public, decide not to leverage this opportunity. I would tell you that the opportunity is great because we have a lot of people struggling and we have a lot of people that need help. And we need to step in and make that difference. So I don't see this as something that has to necessarily have a huge negative impact on our profession, and quite frankly could help our profession jump a level or two over the course of the next year, because we will push ourselves to be better than we've ever been.
Bill Reeb, Chairman of the AICPA, I hope you're right.